What's up, everybody? Going at it again, going after these chicken heads, these does, bald heads. What is today? It is December 10th, Thursday. 3 days left in this rifle doe season. I'm back down here, Greene County 2A, WMU of Pennsylvania, on our farm. It's one of our farms. And yeah, gotta get moving here, gotta get up in there. So get back with you if something happens.
Thursday, December 10th. I think it's the 10th, right? Yeah. 3 days left in the season. Rotting out of the barn this morning. It's a good spot in the evening, but I'll try it in the morning, see if anything cuts through the edge of the field up there. But yeah. I'll be back with you if we get some action. All right, everybody, we're moving. It's 8:35. I was just down here this morning at the bottom by the house in the barn here. Just seeing if anything would slip past the point, but they didn't. You know, in the evening, they're usually in here, and this is where I plan on hunting, either here or over behind the house in the other little barn, watching the other field. But the other night I come down the road, I was hunting up on the ridge all day, and there was 12 of them right up in here. And I didn't take a shot at them. It was getting kind of late there. So this evening, we'll either be right here, or right across the road behind the house in the other barn, watching the bigger field. But right now, we're going to walk up the road, get up on the ridge, and do some still hunting through this morning and early afternoon. All right, be back with you. Well, here's the barn. Kind of beat up, but, you know, that's what we're going to do. My shooting sticks, got all my stuff, got my food in my pack, water, tea, everything. We're going to go on a little hike, see what we can do. All right. See you in a little bit. Alright guys, I'm just walking up the blacktop. You know, I own both sides of the road up here, but just walking up, hit the dirt road, and walk it all the way up to the ridge. A lot of dump trucks coming down the road today. Must be working up at the well. But yeah, that's what we're going to do. As you see, all the nice straight standing timber we have here. I hunted all that ridge Saturday. Or, what was that? Monday I was up there. And I was up there all day, 20-something degrees. And, didn't pay off. I love it up there, though. I could stay up there for days. But then when I walked down to leave, I left a little early just so I can look at the fields, and them 12 deer were down there, and there was more over there behind the house too. Here comes a truck. So we'll get back with you. All right. We're making our way up to the top ridge there. And go up and we'll turn and head east. Along the top, checking down in the overgrown top field and down in the wood line. We got a wood line that cuts through the middle, right out through here. So, all right, I'll talk to you. Well, we made it up top of the pipeline. I'm telling you, it's a climb. We're even higher than the other side from the other day. And that's not it. What you see there is not it. You gotta come up another stack before you even get to there. So yeah. We're gonna get up here and we're gonna work the ridge out east. Looking down in my field there, the overgrown field. catch them in there in the daytime sometimes, down in the center tree line. So, that's a climb, guys, that's a climb, let me tell you. All right, we are up here. So, I'll get back with you if something happens. There's a deer coming. What do you know? It's a freaking buck. Freaking buck, my luck. Coming right up to us. He's gonna step right on us. Not good, not good. Not good. This is not good. Us, man. It's gonna screw us all up. Oh boy. Yep. There he comes. Good setup. Here he comes over the fence. Uh-oh. Yeah, we're busted. Yeah, we ain't got no buck tag, but I wouldn't have shot him anyway. What do you know? Looking for chicken head does, and up comes that basket eight, and he's trying to get up above us, he's gonna wind us. See him up there? He's gonna get behind us. gonna bust us eventually. Here he comes. He'll come right up above us. Sneaky little rascal. Gonna blow my cover up there. I hope he stays on the quad trail. I see his antlers up there. Sneaky little mother effer. I've been sitting here eating my sandwich. I just sat up on this spot about 15 minutes ago. Watching down there, and he came right out of there. My luck, something I can't shoot. See what happens. We got another little buck. See him up there? Little youngster, right up there past the trees. See him cutting through up there? Look like a 4-point or a spike. There he goes, right out the ATV trail. Dang, man. Looking for chicken heads and I can't see one. These bucks keep showing up. We just had another deer. Straight back in there, all I could see was its ass end. Up in there moving around, but I think it went out that way. I don't know what it was. Didn't see any others. Probably another buck, being that it was by itself. Maybe it was by itself, I don't know. I don't know where that deer came from because I've been staring over there. All of a sudden I just catch a glimpse of its ass and its tail moving through over there. So yeah, we'll keep at it. All right guys, look. It's 12:45. I'm coming down. I was, you know, back up on the ridge where I showed you earlier, seeing them three different deer, two bucks, maybe a third buck. But had my gun sitting up on my sticks while I was getting something out of my bag up there. Sticks fell over. Gun hit the ground. So I'm gonna go put this rifle on the bench, make sure everything is still okay. If it's not, get it dialed back in before this evening hunt, because I told you I'm going to be hunting down the bottom out of the barn or the shed. I don't know which field I'm going to take, but I'll figure that out a little bit later. It's just going to be a 50-50 draw, you know, whichever one I pick, that's what it's going to be. So, yeah, I gotta go put this on the bench. Make sure nothing got screwed up, you know, scope-wise, when this thing fell over. I mean, it's stupid of me. I know better. I should never have trusted it, you know. Oh, well. We got the range right down the road here, so I'm gonna go do that. Then, yeah, I'll be back with you for the evening hunt, so stick with me. Alright guys, we're down at the range. I told you I gotta come down and make sure this gun's still true after my mishap. So we're gonna get this done. Make sure we're good. If not, dope it back in and get back over there to the barn for the evening hunt. Alright folks, took a shot at 100. I had two targets up, but they both hit identical. right there. So, gun's good, man. You know, I usually sight in 1.5 inches, 1.75 inches at 100 yards because I like to shoot long distance. But yeah, we're still good. So, back to the farm we go and get ready for our evening hunt. It's early yet, it's only 1:35. Them deer come out to that field around 4:30, 4:20, somewhere around there, you know. So yeah, all right, got that done. And whew, you know, if you ever have any doubts, man, on your weapon, you gotta go put it to the bench. I'm not about wounding animals, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna be sitting there thinking, oh man, this deer comes out, is my gun true or not? I don't want that on my shoulders. You know, and I sure as hell don't want a deer hobbling off on my shoulders, you know, when I go home to a warm bed tonight and that deer's out there freaking wounded up. That's not me. That's not how I do it. And I wish more people practiced the way I do. I know a lot of you do, but there, you know, there are the few that don't. So, yeah, there we go. We're still true. Didn't have to dope scope at all. And we're going to head back over. I mean, we're only 10 minutes from the property. I could have shot there, but I didn't want to be, you know, popping any rounds off. So I just came down to the state game lands, 179 range here. All right, I'll get back with you later on this evening hunt. Let's hope we can get her done. Welcome back, everybody. Hey, we're over in the other shed for this evening. A little beat up in here, but this is a spot here. I'll take the hat off and stick the camera out the window to show you. Right by that first telephone pole in that flat. They usually come out right there. So yeah, it's 3:04 p.m. of course. And well, we got to 5:23 today, I think, is legal shooting time here in Eastern PA or Western PA. So yeah, we got about 2.5 hours if we don't see anything earlier. But I'll be getting back with you if something goes down. All right, stay tuned. All right, everybody. It's down to the golden hour. It's 4:25. Legal shooting hours are over at 5:25. Actually, 5:23. And we're down here, you know, in the shed. I think I already told you this, but I'm recording again just in case. In this little grassy area, they tend to come down here in the evening. Got the GoPro set up right there. So yeah, let's see what happens. We got some deer coming down. Coming down. Oh man, she's coming the other way. No, don't do that. Don't do that, don't do that. I should have popped her right there. Oh. Oh, there's another one coming now. I see him up there, but chance and I didn't do it. Oh, man. Don't tell me he just come home right on the money. drilled her. Yep. Well, I blew that opportunity. I thought they were going to turn and come this way. But they didn't. I had the scope on that bigger one, and where the hell's my gloves at? Alright, let's see what happens. I see two more up there now. I don't know. That was the two from earlier. I don't know. They're gonna continue down either. I got the GoPro on them, but I doubt. There's two of them. They're way up there in the yellow grass. They're up there pretty far. I don't know if you can see them. But I don't know if it's gonna come down or not. Of them now. Which is the bigger? I don't know where the other one went. I'm gonna turn this camera off for a second. This needs a turn. Quartering two, I don't like that shot. This needs a turn left a little bit. Other one's coming down further. I don't know if that's a big one. She went down. She went down. She went down. She went down. All right. She went down. There's that mother deer down lower. Yes. All right, she's down. I seen her go down. So we go up to the pool right up that way a little bit. They're looking over here. But I'm gonna have to go bust them out of here because I'm not gonna wait till it gets dark. She should be down. She should be down. Seen her drop. All right, let's go up. It's gonna get dark, so I'm gonna go get her out of here. Look, they just went back to eating. They don't even care. Had to walk up here. Thank you. dropped her on that shot. There you go, Dad. Your 30-06 does it again. There she is. There she be. Well, let's I'm gonna get her down there. Oh man. Had some serious fragmentation there, girl. Got her tagged up. Whew. One shot knocked her down. There she is. I'm gonna get her cleaned up and get her loaded on the truck. Thanks for joining me here at Off the Hoof Outdoors. It's been a battle. It's been a grind, man. But we got it done today. Two more days left in the season. Rifle doe season here in 2A, Pennsylvania. I do have another doe tag. Not sure if I'll make it back. If not, I got flint loader. Flintlock season after Christmas. I'll be dying for that. So alright, let me get her cleaned out and put on the truck. Thanks for joining me. We'll see you again in the near future.